Today's Radio KD8TTE is going to show you how to create your first radio message and how to send it. We're going to do this in three parts. The first is to create your own radio message using the correct structure. Number two is how to transmit it on a traffic net using correct voice procedure. And number three is going to be, again, how to transmit, this time using correct procedure with CW, which is to say using Morse code. Stick around. Today's demonstration is about making sure that you understand the process. We're going to work by stick, which is to say using a pen and paper, rather than by mill, which is typing. Good operators who are experienced very often will work by mill, but when you're just learning how the process works, it's very helpful to work by stick so that you can see very slowly how things actually come together. You develop a better understanding, and then you're able to work much more smoothly, which is to say much more quickly, after you've got the experience. Today's demonstration is your first radiogram. That's going to keep it simple because we don't have to deal with issues like origination for third parties. We can have control over the message, so we don't have to deal with fancy punctuation rules and so on. For the purpose of the demonstration, we're going to show how you can send a radiogram to me. First, you can begin with any radiogram form that captures this format. It can be the ARRL radiogram form. It can be the RRI radiogram form. It can be the IARU radiogram form. It doesn't matter. Anything that has these basic elements is going to be able to capture the message in a compatible format that can be relayed through the traffic system. So our first order of business is to create the message itself. So you're sending a message to me, and so here's what we'll write. Hello. This is my first radio message. We're going to have a break in thought here, so we're going to use the initial X-ray, and we'll say thanks, and also 7-3, and then you can sign it. The signature goes here down below these groups and above the accounting that happens here. So let's say that we are Bob the Ham, and so what we'll write here is Bob the Ham. And if you like, you can also put your city, state, and zip code. That will help with the routing. You can also put your phone number in there. So let's say that this is Columbus, Ohio, 43215. And your phone number is 614-555-1234. We've now created the message and also where it's coming from, and now we're going to have to create the addressee part. Since it's going to me, because I'm a known traffic handler, you're not going to need to include any more information than this for the message to be able to get to me. If, however, you wanted to put a phone number in there, you can do that. Now, since it's our first message, we're going to use the number 1. Our precedence doesn't have any special urgency, so we're going to call this routine. That's the default precedence for a radio message. No special handling instructions, so we can skip it. The station that we're coming from, that is to say, if your station, and let's just say for the sake of the example, that you're W8OMR. For your own real message, of course, you'll put your own call sign in there. And now the check. That's the number of groups that we have, the number of words in the message. Let's count them up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. We have 10 groups in the text part of the message. We do not include the addressee. We do not include the signature. The text part of the message, 10 groups. That goes into the check. The place of origin, we are in Columbus, Ohio. We use the city,
and the state with a two-digit abbreviation, no comma. The time filed is optional in this case, and so we can just leave it blank. The date is always written with a three-letter abbreviation for the month, and then the day of the month afterward, December 1. At this point now, we have a message that has been captured in the text. We have the signature that shows who sent it, the addressee to show where it's going, and the preamble that gives us the information that is necessary for transmission of the message, routing of the message, and then also for it to be understood as to when it came about and how to get a message sent back. That's all there is to it. You have just created your first radiogram. I look forward to receiving yours.
When you are an experienced traffic handler, you're going to know the voice procedure for how to relay the message, but this is your first one. So for the sake of our demonstration, let's write down everything that we're going to say. That's all of the pro words exactly as we're going to say it, so that when it comes time for us to transmit, all we have to do is read from our notebook. What we're going to write is number. That's the way that we begin transmission. So when we get the call from the station that's going to receive our message, they're going to say ready, or they might say send, but that's going to tell us they're ready to receive the message. So we will say number one, routine, whiskey, 8, Oscar, Mike, Romeo, 1, 0, Columbus, Ohio, December, 1, Matt, I spell, Mike, Alpha, Tango, Tango. Five, break. Now at this point, we're going to need to let go of the push to talk. So this is a note to ourselves: let up on the push to talk, and then listen. And now we can continue if someone does not call in with something of higher precedence, or the receiving station does not ask for part of it to be resent. And then we can continue. Hello, this is my first radio message. Initial X-ray. Thanks. Figures 7-3. Break. And then we again listen. And then we complete with the signature. Bob the Ham, Columbus, Ohio, forward 3215, 61 forward, 555, 123 forward. End, no more. Now that we have our crib sheet where we have everything spelled out, when it comes time for us to make the transmission, all we need to do is read what we've written out. Follow our own notes to ourselves, continue reading, and we are able to finish the whole process. By doing all of this ahead of time, we have the opportunity to review our work and to make corrections as necessary. If you notice, when I was creating my crib sheet, I forgot to put the last name of my addressee in place. So, after Matt, I spell Mike Alpha Tango Tango, I would need to insert Curtin, I spell Charlie Uniform Romeo Tango India November. Thus, my crib sheet is correct. When we're operating on air, we're going to sound like an old pro. By doing this, by hearing others, by practicing, you won't need to have this kind of note to yourself, and you will learn correct voice procedure, and it will become easier and easier until it gets to the point where it's just second nature and you don't even need to think about how to do this. Of course, after you finish transmitting your message, it's going to be important to make sure that you have done your accounting. On your radiogram form, always make sure that you keep track of the accounting. That is to say, where you received it from. Well, in this case, we wrote it, so we didn't receive it from anywhere else. But where did we send it? Well, our example was we sent it to W6RRI. And let's say that we did that on the evening net for December 1st. And the time that we sent that, local time, was at 19:23. That's the time that the station W6RRI's operator said Roger, and that means this message is now off of our station and is now on their station. It's now their responsibility to move the message forward. That's all it takes for sending your first radiogram by voice procedure. Now, what happens if you're working on a CW net? We're going to demonstrate that with exactly the same message if we're doing the transmission there. We're going to use Morse code, and I'm going to put the translation of the sound into text on screen so you're able to follow along even if you are not a CW operator. And of course, just like when we sent by voice procedure, we maintain the accounting record showing transmission of the message on our copy of the radiogram. A lot of people are put off or intimidated by the formality of the traffic system. Don't worry about it. Remember that it exists for a reason. You are not a slave to the procedure. The procedure is there to support you. What is your mission? Your mission is to get the message word for word, letter for letter, from one point to another. The procedures exist to help you to that end. Daily operations are important because they give everyone the chance to practice the fundamental skills of originating, sending, receiving, and delivering messages. You are going to make mistakes as you go through this process, as you are conducting daily operations, and that's okay. The important point is to make sure that you learn from your mistakes, that you do not repeat them, because when it comes time for you to train others, and when it comes time for you to operate in an emergency condition, you will be squared away, you will be able to do the job well, you will be part of a system that provides a viable means of communication in emergencies and in disasters. That's the point. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please share it with others and encourage them to develop these fundamental skills. This is Radio KD8TTE, out.